How's your day going?
Good.
I have a coloring sheet that we can color about welcoming your new cells. Okay? From your mom. Yeah? And we could play a little, do some preparation. Do you want to help take the dressing off?
For Lucy Weiss's bone marrow transplant to be successful, she must first undergo a full regimen of chemotherapy.
Does it hurt to get the dressing change done?
Kind of, but when you...
To make sure Lucy understands what is about to happen to her, a recreational therapist explains the procedure.
And what do we use this for? What are we trying to get rid of?
Germs.
Germs, because we need to...
There are significant risks associated with bone marrow transplants. Somewhere around 5 to even 15% chance of dying because of, you know, infection and the toxicities of chemotherapy.
You want me to help you?
Ironically, the life-saving chemotherapy that makes Lucy's bone marrow transplant possible has its origins in war. In World War I, the German military was the first to use mustard gas, a chemical weapon, in combat. It proved an especially efficient killer. One day alone, it killed 5,000 Allied troops and was the cause of nearly 100,000 deaths by war's end. Worried that it would be used again in the Second World War, two American scientists, Alfred Gilman and Lewis Goodman, were tasked with studying this deadly gas. They found that it attacked the body's bone marrow and killed the white blood cells within it. Gilman and Goodman immediately saw the medical potential and produced the first versions of chemotherapy. Nearly 20 years later, right here at the NIH, numerous chemotherapy drugs were first used in combination. They were later found to be effective not only as a treatment for cancer, but as a way to prep a patient for bone marrow transplant. The legacy of this research is what Lucy Weiss will be receiving today.
This is the pentastatin for Lucy this morning. It is a chemotherapy that she's getting prior to her transplant. Hey, double check it for me.
Weiss, Lucy, Janelle, that is all mixed up.
It is. They put your last name first. You want it on your leg?
Yeah.
We can put it on your leg.
Lucy knows that she's having her bone marrow transplant. There's been a lot of waiting, months and months of waiting. It feels like we're finally doing it.
I feel a little scared, but I'm mostly excited.
All right. This just goes through your IV. All right, so this will be an hour and 20 minutes.
Hey, Lucy. You doing okay?
Chemotherapy is not an option for Deidra Williams. Her organs, damaged from sickle cell pain crises like the one she recently survived, will not tolerate it.
To connect it right here.
Is it cold, I think?
No, but it needs to be protected from the light, and that's why there is this bag.
Developing a safe bone marrow transplant for patients like Deidra has been the lifelong mission of her doctor, John Tisdale.
We started asking the question, can we do transplants without completely knocking out the bone marrow and get enough take to fix the disease?
Dr. Tisdale's experimental trial was made possible by the discovery that to cure sickle cell, doctors only need to replace some of a patient's bone marrow. The trick was in designing a protocol that sickle cell patients could tolerate.
Morning.
Morning.
All right, well, you look all settled in here.
Yeah, man, I'm got my hat, my earrings, I'm ready to do this. Got my inspirational cards, my little focus points. I'm a little nervous, but I can do this.
Yeah.
So.
I have a few things to say, but I guess you guys can continue, so. Okay, so starting today, it's gonna be bad. You're gonna have a lot of symptoms, but those are actually the worst day of being here in the hospital. So I just wanna get you mentally prepared. You know, we have people who seem pretty stoic, they crash. And we have other people, you know, if you blow on them, they will, you know, get really terrible, but they do fine. So we've really seen both, and it's really hard to predict. So I know you like to be prepared, and you want
to. I do like to be prepared, tell me the truth.
Yeah, so it's gonna be difficult.
For me, it is like a battle.
Yeah.
So I'm ready to go to war. I'm ready to do this. I'm ready to fight.
Good.
To get to the other side.
All right, we'll check in on you later.
Okay, thanks, right. Dr. Shape. We're on our way to destroying my immune system. It's like my body's army. And they are going to pretty much put my body's army to sleep. Is that a good way to say it?
Yeah. In a way, yes.
In a way?
So call me, I'll be right outside. Any itching, sudden chills or shakes? I'm just not feeling good, okay?
Thank you.
This intensive treatment is no walk in the park. They can have fever, they'll have shaking chills. People have said, you know, it's like being run over by a truck. They'll have pains that, you know, in different places, even though you think that she might be used to having pain, but these will elicit different kind of pain from her sickle cell.